Hello students, I welcome you all in the next lecture of science. In the previous lecture, we have completed with chapter number 8, that is our skeletal system and the skin. I discussed all the workbook exercises also, and the PDF of same is sent on your WhatsApp group. So as I have instructed yesterday, complete your workbook on time. Today we are starting with our next lesson. Okay, so the next lesson here is lesson number 9, motion and types of motion. Okay, so here you can see some pictures, and here you can see various types of motion in these objects. Okay, motion means what? When the objects are moving, then we say that moving objects are in motion. Like you can see that this ball is kicked by this boy. That means the ball has given motion to the ball. Okay. So when he applied force here, that caused the motion of the ball. You can see the different type of motion here, that is spinning of top. That the top is spinning, spinning in the circular way. Here you can see the boy is juggling the ball, correct? This is also one different type of motion. You can see the path of the motion here. You can see the motion of the aeroplane. Here you can see the potter is making pot on the wheel. Okay, so the motion of the wheel here is circular motion. You can see these motions. Okay, so such motions we observe in our day-to-day life. And we see the moving objects also. So we say that the moving objects are in motion. Okay. So here you will observe that every motion is different here. All the motions are not of same type. So today in this chapter, we are going to discuss about the types of motion. Okay. So for that, first of all, let us try to understand the meaning of the word motion, and for that purpose you need to understand the word displacement. Okay, the word displacement is similar to that of distance, but the difference is there that in distance we don't mention direction, but for displacement we mention direction. Direction is very, very important here. So there is a difference between distance and displacement. Though both represent the distance covered, in distance direction is not there, but in displacement direction is very, very important. Take the example, suppose we say that the bus covered 1 kilometer in 5 minutes. Okay, so here 1 kilometer distance is given, but nowhere direction is given. But suppose you are standing at one point and I am instructing you that go 10 feet or move 10 feet from your place. So then you will think that where to move, whether to move on left, whether to move on right, whether to go front or whether to go back. So if I mention that move 10 feet in east, immediately you will start moving in east. So this is the basic difference between distance and displacement, which you need to understand. Okay. Now here you will observe this. You can observe this picture here, that a lady is sitting in train and she is looking outside the window. So when she is looking outside the window and the train is moving in the forward direction, what she can see is the trees. They are moving in the backward direction. Okay. Now here in this case, the lady is stationary in the train. Train is moving, and because of that, she could see the trees are moving backwards. But are the trees moving really? You know that trees are fixed at one place. So since the train is moving, because of that, she can feel the movement of tree here. Okay. So here, if we are standing at one place on the road, suppose, then we can see that many vehicles, they are moving in front of us. Okay, so that means the vehicles are in the state of motion. we are stable. And when we talk about this lady who is sitting in the train, she is stable, but the train is moving. Because of that, she feels that the object outside are moving backward. Okay, so here what happens is, if the object is seen by the observer to change the place continuously, then we say that the object is in motion. Okay, and this change of place of an object is called as what? Displacement. The object is moving from one place to another. Change of place takes place, that is called as what? Displacement. Okay, here when the object is in motion, it continuously undergoes the displacement. Displacement takes place continuously. So by using this word displacement, we can define motion as the continuous displacement of an object is called as motion. Okay, so I hope you must have understood these two definitions. First definition here, see, change of place of an object is called a displacement. Mark this. This is the definition of displacement. Okay, that means the object covers some distance, that is called as displacement. And here the continuous displacement of the object is called as what? Motion. So by using the word displacement, we can define motion. Okay, so here when the object is in motion, it shows a continuous displacement. Now let us try to understand more about motion. That means we are going to learn the types of motion. In that, the very first type is linear motion. Okay, that means we are going to see here main two types, linear motion and non-linear motion. See here, linear word is having, linear is having the word line. So that word is very much important, that the motion is said to be a linear motion when the displacement takes place in a straight line or in the same direction. Okay, so here this is the definition of linear motion, that when the displacement takes place in a straight line or in the same direction, it is called as what? The linear motion. You can see the train. If the train is moving on the straight track in one direction only, we say that the motion is linear. If the road is straight and if the vehicle is moving on that road, then we say that the motion is linear. Okay, so when the motion is in a straight line or in the same direction, it is called as linear motion. Or simply you can define the motion of the object in a straight line. This word is important. The motion of the object in a straight line is called as linear motion. Okay, so here whenever the object is in linear motion, always it shows its displacement along a straight line. Displacement is always along a straight line in the same direction. Okay, now here one more example is given here. If you are standing on chair and if you release the ball from your hand and it falls on the floor, then what you can say about this, that this is which type of motion? So you will say that it is also a linear motion. But see, what happens here is the ball is at stationary in your hand, but when you release it, its speed goes on increasing and afterwards finally it give its impact on the floor. Okay, so here motion from a dropping motion is also a linear motion. Okay, now let us try to understand more about the linear motion. In linear motion also we have two types, uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. So let us understand that what is uniform motion and what is non-uniform linear motion. Okay, so for this we are going to take one simple example. Okay, so here two examples are given. The first example is that the motion of the soldiers in the parade, and the second is given as the girl coming down from the slide. Also here you can see the motion of the aeroplane, the motion of the bullet from the gun. Okay, so these are different examples given here. Okay, so here what you can say about the motion of soldiers in a parade. So what we can say is motion of the soldiers is the motion of the soldiers is same. That means we can see uniformity in their motion. You can see their legs, how they are moving in the uniform manner. Okay, so during that period you cannot see a slight difference also in their motion. But here when the girl is coming down from the slide, what you can say is the speed of the girl, or in the beginning at the top the girl is at rest, but as she slides down its speed goes on increasing, or the motion is faster and faster. The girls come down faster and faster. That means the speed goes on increasing continuously here. Here the speed is not increasing. They are walking uniformly. You cannot see a slight difference also. Okay? So this motion of marching soldiers is called as uniform linear motion, because their speed remains same throughout. And we cannot see the change in the motion here. On the other hand, when the girl is coming down from the slide, it is called as non-uniform motion, because her speed is increasing continuously. Okay, so these are two different types of motions: uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. In uniform linear motion, the speed is same throughout, and in non-uniform linear motion the speed is not same throughout. Take a simple example. Suppose you are going by a car on a straight road and the road is quite clear, no traffic is there, like express highway you can think of. So on that, if you are going with the continuous speed, that means 120 kilometers per hour, then your motion is what? Uniform linear motion. But think on the road, suppose you are going by a car on the roads of Virar, then what will happen? Can you go in uniform motion? You have to change your speed so many times. You have to stop somewhere. Sometimes your speed is more, sometimes your speed is less. So that is the example of what? Non-uniform linear motion. Okay, so we can compare now the difference between these two: uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion, which are the two types of linear motion. So when the distance traversed by an object along a straight line in unit time is continuously same, the motion is said to be uniform linear motion. As I gave you the example on expressway, that you are covering 120 kilometers per hour, that means it is an example of uniform linear motion. But in case of non-uniform linear motion, the distance traversed by the object along a straight line in unit time keeps on changing. Sometimes you are going slow, sometimes you are going fast. So that motion is called as what? Non-uniform linear motion. I hope you must have understood these two types of linear motion. They are which? Uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. Okay? Now, let us go further. Okay. Now we are going to see the second type of motion, that is non-linear motion. Okay. So what we have seen for the linear motion, that the object moves in straight line, then we say that the motion is a linear motion. Okay. But when the object does not move in a straight line, that time we say that the motion is a non-linear motion. Okay, so here also in non-linear motion we are having different types. So what you have to keep in mind, that the main two types of motion are linear and non-linear. So linear means what? The motion of the object in a straight line. There we have seen two types, that is uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. Okay, now we are going towards second main type, that is non-linear motion. So the object when the object does not move in a straight line, it is called as what? Non-linear motion. Now here, there are many types under this. So, we will try to understand these types of non-linear motion one by one. Okay? So, let us start. In that, first, we are going to see oscillatory motion. So, here one question is asked. What kind of movement does a swing in the park show? So, this is your favorite game. That swinging on the swing is your favorite game. Okay? So, here, what kind of movement do you see? So, what we can see here is the swing is going back and forth again and again. Okay? So, we can see back and forth movement of the swing. It goes to one end, it stops at that end, and again it starts moving backward. In the backward direction also, it is reaching the second end, and again it starts moving in the forward direction. Okay? So, this movement is repeated again and again. And if we try to compare the time here, see, if the girl starts from here, going back and coming back again to the same place, this is called as one oscillation. Okay. So, here, or this is called as each movement of the swing, or called as one oscillation. So, time taken here for one oscillation, every time, nearly it is same. Okay. So, this way we can say that the motion of the swing is the oscillatory motion. So, here swing always takes the motion that is back and forth. So, this type of motion is called as oscillatory motion, or the movement of the swing you can call as oscillatory motion. So, such many examples of oscillatory motion we can see in our day-to-day life. Like you can see the movement of pendulum of clock. Many clocks are having pendulum at the bottom, and that pendulum also moves back and forth continuously. Then the movement of the wings of the bird is also the oscillatory motion. Then the needle of sewing machine, or the vibrating diaphragm of tabla or drum. So, all these instruments also they show the oscillatory motion, because the diaphragm moves back and forth continuously when we hit on that. Okay. So, these are the various examples of oscillatory motion which we see in our day-to-day life. Okay. So, let us see now here the definition. The motion of the body that is oscillating, that is swinging back and forth, is called as oscillatory motion. Okay. So, this is the definition of oscillatory motion. Now, here they have asked you one question. In which musical instruments can you see oscillatory motion? So, just think of the musical instruments. Can you guess the musical instruments where you can see the oscillatory motion? Okay. So, you can think of sitar, then violin, veena, all these musical instruments, tabla, all these musical instruments, they show the oscillatory motion. Because when you twist the swing of the instrument, it starts moving back and forth, and those vibrations, they give out sound. Okay. So, this we can see this vibrating motion or oscillatory motion in the musical instruments like violin, tabla, then sitar, veena, guitar, all these are the examples of such musical instruments. Okay. Let us go further. So, see here you can see the examples of non-linear motion. Again, you can see here from the circus, these are the swings given here, how those girls are moving. Okay. So, here also you can see the oscillatory motion. Here you can see the oscillatory motion where I said that pendulum of the clock, it moves continuously back and forth. Then wings of the bird, you can see the oscillatory motion here. Now here, you can see circular motion. Here you can see circular motion in merry-go-round. Here also you can see circular motion. So, these are the different examples of non-linear motion. That means, the motion do not take place in a straight line, but it takes place in different direction. The object is moving continuously in different directions. It is not in the same direction. Okay. So these are the examples of non-linear motion. From that we have seen the first one as oscillatory. Okay. Now let us go towards the next motion. So here we are going towards the second type, that is called as circular motion. So the best example of circular motion here, the motion of the hands of clock. You can see that the hands of the clock, all the three hands, second hand, minute hand and hour hand, they always move in a circular manner. Then you can see the movement of the blades of the fan, the movement of giant wheel, merry-go-round. Okay, so they are completing one round in a circular way, or they follow the circular route. Okay, so such type of motion is called as what? Circular motion. So in day-to-day life also we can see many examples of circular motion. Also you try to find out more examples of circular motion. Observe the things in your day-to-day life and you can give the more examples of circular motion. As we have just seen, you have seen the motor. Okay, so motor, you can imagine mixer. See, the blade of the mixer rotates in the circular manner, so that motor gives that circular motion to the blades of the mixer or to the blades of the fan. So all these are the motions, examples of circular motion. That in nearly all the electronic appliances they have motor, and in that they have fans or blades which move in a circular manner. Okay, so you can think of so many such examples. So let us see the definition of circular motion. The motion of an object along a circular path is called as circular motion. You have to keep in mind this definition, that when the object moves in a circular path, the motion of the object is called as circular motion. Now related to this, we are moving towards the next type of motion, that is called as what? Periodic motion. Okay, so here these two are closely related, but every time we cannot say that the circular motion is periodic or the periodic motion is circular, but still they are closely related here. So here when the object passes through certain point again and again in a fixed period of time, it is called as what? Periodic motion. Like you know that the hands of the clock you can think of, correct? Second hand, how much time it takes to complete that one revolution there? You know that 1 minute. So after 1 minute, every time it is passing through the certain point again and again. Similarly for minute hand also, it takes 1 hour to complete that one circle. Okay, so all such motions, they are called as what? Periodic motions. You can think of day and night, they are also periodic motions. Okay, sunrise and sunset, they also take place at a certain period of time. Okay, so they are also the type of what? Periodic changes, or you can see the periodic motions. So then the rotation of the earth around itself, you know that earth takes 1 day to complete one rotation, and earth takes 1 year to complete one revolution around the sun. So the motion of the earth is also a periodic motion. That means what? The object is taking a fixed time, and in that fixed time it is going through that certain point again and again. So that is the example of what? Periodic motion. Okay, so the motion of the hands of the clock is circular also, and it's periodic also. Okay, so that is why I told you that they are closely related. Now the motion of the swing, is what? It is periodic, but it is not circular. Okay, so this way you can relate them. So motion of the swing is oscillatory also and periodic also. Try to understand the difference here, that the motion of hands of clock is circular also and periodic also. Okay, so we can say that oscillatory motion and circular motion are the types of periodic motion. Okay, they come under periodic motion. Both are periodic motions. So I hope you must have understood the concept of circular motion, periodic motion and oscillatory motion. Okay, let us go further now. Now here more examples are given about the periodic motion, or more information is given. I have already given you this information that what time does the clock hand take. Okay, so here it is given the example of minute hand, that it takes 60 minutes every time. So while if you think of a merry-go-round, then it completes one round nearly in the same period of time. Okay, so such motion is called as what? Periodic motion, because this motion takes place after a definite period of time. Okay, so you have to compare the periodic motion and the circular motion, also periodic motion and the oscillatory motion. Or you can say that oscillatory motion and circular motion, they are types of periodic motion. Both of them are periodic motions only. Okay, so now here one more question is asked, correct, that which type of motion are seen when a girl rides a bicycle as shown here. Okay, so which type of motion can you see here? Is it a linear motion? No. So this is which type of motion? Non-linear motion. Also, if she is moving with the constant speed, then she is passing through the same point nearly after every same period of time. So you can say that the motion of the girl is periodic. Okay, so this way you have to give the answer. Now let us go further. The next type we will see. The next type of motion is called as what? Random motion. Okay, so for this here two examples are given. Suppose you are playing in garden and if you see the butterfly, and if you start chasing that butterfly, then what will happen? See, the question is asked, while chasing a butterfly in the garden, do you run along a definite path or in the same direction all the time? No. Answer is what? No. Because sometimes the butterfly, it settles on the flower. Sometimes it is going to one direction, afterwards it is going to other direction. That means the butterfly is changing the direction continuously. Okay, that means we are not running along a definite path, or we are not moving in the same direction, but we run anyhow in attempt to follow the butterfly. Okay, we want to follow the butterfly, so as the butterfly is changing direction, we are running anyhow behind that butterfly. Okay, so this butterfly is constantly flitting from one flower to another flower. There is no specific direction of motion. So the motion in which the direction changes continuously and the speed also changes continuously, it is called as what? Random motion. Okay, so the motion that changes its direction and the speed continuously or constantly, it is called as what? Random motion. Also, you can see the example of this boy. If the boy is playing with the ball, the boy can kick the ball with its legs also, or it can throw the ball in any direction with his hands. So here also the motion is the random motion. One more example you can take, that is football ground. Okay, the players, those who are playing football, they are continuously changing the direction of the football according to their need. So that motion there is also of type random motion. So see, the example is given here, that the motion of the players playing the football is also of type what? Random motion. More examples you can give of the crawling baby, or the animals which are wandering in the jungle. That is the example of what? Random motion. That means no direction or no speed is followed here. The speed and the direction, they are changing continuously. So such motion is called as what? Random motion. Okay, so I hope you must have understood the types of motion. Now try to understand main two types, linear and non-linear. Under linear we have two more types, uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. And for non-linear motion, we have seen four types. First is oscillatory, second is circular, third is periodic, and fourth is random motion. Okay. So in this way, we have covered all types of motions. Okay. Now, the last part of the concept of speed is remaining. Okay. So that part I will complete in next lecture. So till that, students, you read the lesson carefully. Try to understand all types of motions, because this is an important chapter. If you understand this concept well, it is better for you to understand it in the higher standards. So read the chapter well. Try to understand all the definitions. Okay. So students, today I am stopping here. Till that, stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Thank you.